right on next. Second application, mesomeric effect. Mesomeric. This is the second electronic effect. Resonance is also an electronic effect. Resonance, mesomeric effect. The second electronic effect after inducting effect. Okay. Mesomeric effect, we also call it as resonance effect. Both are same thing. Resonance effect. Like inductive effect will have plus I and minus I. What is plus I? What is plus I? Electron releasing. Electron releasing. So here also we have plus M and minus M. Plus means electron releasing. Okay. So you can write this as plus M or minus M effect. Plus M is nothing but plus R and minus M is nothing but minus R. Both are same. Okay. So plus M group are what? These are the groups which can release electron pair. Electron pair donor. Okay. Plus M groups are electron pair donor. And what is the electron pair involved into this? Either pi bond or? Pi bond or don't pair. Because we know in mesomeric effect resonance, sigma bond does not involve. Right? Pi electrons or lone pair. Okay. So plus M groups are those groups which has at least one lone pair present on the first atom, right on. These are the groups which has at least one lone pair present on the first atom. First atom, which, like, suppose you have a group benzene pair, whatever group is attached, suppose NH2, right? NH2 has one lone pair. So this is the first atom. Means the group that is attached with the benzene ring, the first atom of that group, or the atom which attached with the benzene ring, if that atom contains at least one lone pair, it has plus M effect. Okay, it's very important. Plus M effect. I'll give you the examples, but this is a general thing you should memorize. Okay, the first atom or the atom of the group which is attached with the ring, that atom must have at least one lone pair. Then it behaves as electron pair.
So the previous question, wouldn't there be mesomeric effect also?
Where?
The previous question.
This one, हाँ तो वही है. OH का भी whatever resonating structure we are drawing, वही वाला. OH का we have done the RS for this, no? So this is mesomeric effect because it is releasing electron to the ring. The structure that you draw, that is mesomeric effect.
So what about the chlorobenzene?
I'll come to that. I'll come to that. Wait. Okay, I'll come.
Oh, it's a plus M effect means that it has more tendency to resonate.
No. Plus C. First of all, this effect we define for a group which is attached on any conjugated ring. Ab wo benzene bhi ho sakta hai, any other conjugated ring is possible. Conjugation should be there because for resonance, the conjugation is the basic requirement. Correct? So, plus M effect is defined for a group. And this group, these are the groups which can release electron to the ring, correct? And it can release electron only when it has extra electron or available electron. Available electron means what? Lone pair of electron. Bond pair, so it cannot release, right? So this has at least one lone pair, so it can release this electron pair to this ring and this pi electron shift over here, and then further you can draw the resonating effect, correct? So plus M group are those groups which can release electron pair to the ring, right? Release, not withdraw. Okay. Condition is what? The atom must has at least one lone pair. Now, what are the examples we have? We can have OH plus M group, because oxygen has how many electrons? Two lone pairs on this, right? It can release electron. OCH3 plus M effect. Okay. Next is NH2 plus M effect. NR2.
What is R?
R is alkyl group. CH3, ethyl, methyl, propyl, whatever. Okay, NR2. We can write O. C double bond O. R. Plus M. Like oxygen, if you replace this oxygen with SH, this is also plus M, you won't get this anywhere, but oxygen, sulfur, you can
replace. So what is R?
What is R2? R2 is this. That's why I wanted to do it. Nomenclature first. R is means both alkyl group are present. Means all this hydrogen is replaced by this alkyl group. Okay. Okay. See, one thing you just try to understand here. This group means what? These groups, when attached to the ring, it donates electron to the ring. Okay. Now, if you compare the plus M nature of OCS3 and OC double bond OCS3, which one has more plus M nature?
OCS3.
Why OCS3?
Answer is correct, but why? See, here, first of all, both will show plus M. Any doubt in this?
No, because it can show plus M.
But here what happens, this lone pair is also involved in resonance with this oxygen. Pi sigma pi. Lone pair sigma pi. This pi electron will withdraw this electron towards the side. Electron releasing tendency is less for this, in comparison to this. See, nitrogen has lone pair on it, and this lone pair is in conjugation with this pi bond. Correct? Yeah, so what we can do, we can put this lone pair into bond pair like this, and this pi electron shift onto this carbon. So what, eventually what is happening, this NH2 group is giving electron to this ring. That's why it is plus N group. Clear?
So in that OCH3, can't it also be OR?
OR in general, you can write OR, but what? OR you can write. This is very important. You have to identify first the nature of the group. Then you can find out the other properties. Okay? So for plus M, the first atom must have at least one lone pair on. Okay? Next one, write down NH. This one example also. NH.
Because
there, C double bond OCS3. These are plus M group, the group which shows plus M. Now, can you tell me if you compare the plus M effect of this one and this one, which one has more plus M effect?
NH2
will have more. Logic is same. Okay, write down the example. What about halogens? X has lone pair. X has three lone pair, right? Does this halogen show plus M effect?
Yes.
Condition of plus M is there?
Yeah.
There, right? So when this halogen attached with the ring, any chlorine, whatever it is, attached to the ring, since it has lone pair, so it can show resonance like this. So it has plus M nature, right? It has plus M nature. Plus M nature it has, but its effective effect is this, minus I. Usually what happens, resonating effect dominates inductive effect. Means plus M always dominates plus I or minus I. Means effect of resonance is more than that of inductive effect. Means suppose if you have two molecules are there, both has carbocation, one carbocation is getting stabilized by plus M effect and other carbocation is getting stabilized by plus I effect. The one which shows plus M effect is more stable, right? Because plus M dominates plus I. Basically, in general, we can say mesomeric effect or resonance dominates I effect. So usually what happens, you see, when oxygen attached here, for this example, you see, nitrogen and oxygen bond we have, right? Nitrogen is more electronegative. Yes. So this nitrogen shows minus I also. If I ask you what all effects possible here, you can answer minus I and plus M. Both effects possible. But which one is dominating, according to that we'll get the answer. But we know mesomeric effect dominates I effect. So plus M of NH2 dominates minus I nature. Yeah, only in case of halogen. Only in case of halogen, its minus I effect dominates plus M nature. You must remember this, very important. Any doubt in this? Right? So condition for plus M is the first atom must have at least one lone pair. halogen has three lone pair, but its minus I dominates. Okay, not
that's
plus.
An exception.
Kind of exception.
Yeah.
Okay. Usually plus M dominates minus I or plus I. Okay. This example you see. Carbocation stability. Which one is more stable?
That one.
See, in this what effect we have?
You have
what effect? Electronic effect. I tertiary so plus I. Plus I, 3 degree carbocation. See, when you
minus M,
minus M, why?
Because it's accepting.
No, but there's no
double bond.
There's no conjugation.
Wait.
No, okay. Just one. Wait. This carbocation will have plus I. Yes or no?
Yeah.
No. CS3 is giving electron. CS3 and C2H5 this side. Right? It is alkyl group, no? Alkyl group has plus I nature. It's CH2, CH3. Both have plus I effect. Alkyl group are, you are not the first plus, no? I'll share the video, okay? So these are alkyl group, and alkyl group are electron releasing. It's plus I nature. So here we have only plus I effect. Here what we have? This two CH3 shows plus I, but because of this pi bond, this positive charge is in conjugation, right? This shows plus M effect. So effective, the plus M is effective over here. Means we can say the second carbocation is getting stabilized through resonance, mesomeric effect, plus M effect. And plus M dominates plus I, that's why the second one is more stable. Order is this.
So can't we also just say it has more pi bonds?
No, that is only possible for RS of same molecule. These are different molecules. Because it is pi sigma vacant orbital, first type of conjugation. Plus M, you can also say resonance. Through resonance, it is stable. Better write resonance, not plus M. Resonance, you write. Resonance, don't write plus M, resonance.
Or can we just say 1 pi bond, 0 pi bond?
Where? No, 1 pi bond, 0 pi bond is only applicable for RS of same molecular ion. The 8 rules I have given you, know. It is, you can compare RS of same molecule. These are two different molecules. What I am telling you, we have two carbocation, we have to compare the stability. So, first, mein toh I effect hai. Second में resonance, resonance dominates high effect, second वाला more stable, that is it. So when you finish resonance, hyperconjugation and all, you'll get the, you know, questions in which high effect, hyperconjugation, resonance all are taking place. So according to the dominating effect, we'll find out the answer. Even in this one, I did not discuss plus H effect, hyperconjugation. Here plus I and plus H is also possible. Hyperconjugation भी लग रहा है, right? And hyperconjugation dominates I effect. Resonance dominates hyperconjugation. So order is RHI, decreasing order. Okay. So you have to first identify what all effects are there, and then you can compare. Okay. So we'll do enough examples, you'll understand. Okay. But you have to focus. Okay. So write down next minus M group, just reverse of this. Okay. Minus M group, you write down. It is electron withdrawing group. Okay. Electron withdrawing groups are those groups actually, in which between first and second atom will have multiple bonds. Like suppose X is attached to the ring, okay? X is, I'll suggest you to memorize this general condition, because there are many examples, it is difficult to memorize the nature of the group, plus M, minus M, and what is that. So general thing you must remember, the first atom which attached with the ring, TH, and the second atom, Y suppose, okay? We must have multiple bonds between the two. It can be a double bond, it can be a triple bond. And if it is there, then why it is minus M? Because you see this example. If you have this ring, right, and one group say CHO is attached. CHO is this C double bond OH, right? So since this double bond is present, pi sigma pi conjugation we have, correct? So this oxygen takes electron pair, and this withdraws electron from the ring, and that's why it is minus MF. So this conjugation, if it is not there, then it cannot withdraw electron from the ring. Since carbon does not have lone pair, so it cannot donate the electron. And this pi sigma pi conjugation we have, so it can, this pi goes onto this oxygen, then this carbon takes pi bond from the ring, so eventually it is withdrawing electrons.
So the conditions are reverse of minus M.
Exactly.
Yes, exactly. Minus M is electron withdrawing from the ring. Plus M is electron releasing. So minus M ke liye, this is the condition. Between first and second atom, we must have double bond, or if the atom which is attached with the ring has vacant orbital. Then again, we have pi sigma vacant orbital possible. So this is also the type of conjugation here. If this three condition is there, then the box means vacant orbital. This box means vacant orbital. Okay, vacant orbital. Example, you write down NO2. You see NO2, the structure is this, N double bond O. Double bond. We can also write this aldehyde, C double bond OH. Okay, we can also write C double bond OR. Okay, we can also write C double bond O, OR, C double bond O, OH. Okay, BH2. If BH2 is attached with the ring, it also shows minus M effect, because boron has vacant T orbital on it. Boron is vacant pure.
So, pH means phenol, right?
Phenyl. This ring.
Phenyl.
It's not phenol, it's phenyl.
Oh, it's benzene with bond.
This is phenyl. One open bond here. This group can be anything. Can be anything. pH is this phenyl group. We can have cyanide, C triple bond N. All these groups shows minus M effect. Electron withdrawing nature. Then, I'll write down some examples here. You have to tell me first what all effects are possible and which one is dominating. Okay? So for example, you see, you have benzene ring, NH2 group is attached. OCS3.
So, but like, what is the difference if there's plus an effect or minus I effect? So if you got plus I effect dominating, does that mean stability or something?
What do you want to say? Why are you asking that what all effects are possible? That's what you
want to say. So like, what do we get by finding out which plus M effect of minus R? Only stability you
know. See, when you get that question, no? So you should know what effect is taking place. Then only you can compare. Right, it is not required here, suppose. If I ask you what effects possible here, what is the answer?
Plus M.
Plus M and?
Minus I.
Minus I to hamesha hoga na, because nitrogen is more electronegative than this carbon. So if I ask you what all effects possible, you can answer plus M and minus I. But the nature of the compound is according to plus M, because plus M is dominating. Yeah, so when you find out the stability or anything, so you have to think according to plus M effect, not minus I. Okay? So in this one more NH, C double bond OR. Okay. Here, what all effects are there? Plus M and minus I. Plus M dominates. Here, what we have? Plus M, minus I. Why minus I we have? Because carbon oxygen will have electronegativity difference. Right? And that is a permanent effect. So, that bond pair of electron is always shifted towards the more electronegative atom. Okay? What about this NR2 plus M dominates minus I, C double bond OR minus M and only minus M, because this carbon is sp2, this carbon is also sp2, there is no electronegativity, only minus M. even here also this is SP and this is SP2. So minus M and minus I.
Oh, wait.
It is SP. It is SP. It is SP2. SP
yes,
is
yes,
more
yes.
electronegative.
Yeah.
So minus M, minus I, but minus M dominates minus I. Here it is plus M, minus I, plus M dominates. So plus M or mesomeric effect always dominates inductive effect, except in the case of what? Except in the case of halogen. So if you have halogen attached on this, halogen has T lone pair, it can show plus M effect, it can also show minus I effect, but minus I of halogen dominates plus M. Right? In case of halogen, inductive effect dominates. Okay, so this is done. Next class we'll start with aromaticity. Aromaticity will do this.